Hello, today we're going to build this sunflower out of the Circuit Playground Express. The yellow lights mean that it's above a certain light threshold and the sunflower is still because it's happy and it's in a bright sunny spot. But if we cover up the light sensor on the Circuit Playground Express, now it's in the darkness and it's going to move to the left or to the right and look for a sunnier spot. And when it finds it, then it will stop again. So the first part of this video, I'm going to explain how to build the actual physical sunflower. And the second part of this video, we're going to go over how to code the sunflower. For the stem of the sunflower, I used two popsicle sticks. They're a little bit thicker and I painted them green. You can use as many sticks as you want, but the more you use, the taller your sunflower will be and the harder it will be on your servo motor. So after they were dried, I glued them together by overlapping them a lot to provide more strength between the two of them. And then I moved on to creating the flower. I used yellow construction paper and I folded it up into about the shape I wanted for the petals. And by folding it, I could cut out more than one petal at a time. And then I traced the outline of what I wanted it to look like and cut it out. And I used three sheets of paper to cut out a lot of petals. And then I traced the Circuit Playground Express board on a black piece of construction paper and cut that out. And that was going to be the base of the sunflower. Using Elmer's glue, I added layer upon layer of petals to the outside. And when this was all dry, I glued the Circuit Playground Express board to the front of the sunflower and the popsicle stick to the back. And on the back of the popsicle stick, I attached my battery. The smaller the battery you can use, the better, because it's less weight for the servo to have to move around. At the bottom of the popsicle stick, I glued the arm of the servo motor, and inside the flower pot at the top, I glued the servo. And I made sure the servo was in the upright position and the wires were sticking out of the top. And when you attach the servo arm to the servo, you want to make sure that the flower can move to the left and to the right as many degrees as possible. It probably can't go the full 180, but make sure that you go close to the edges of the pot. You might have to play around with where the servo motor and the arm attach. And to wire it up, the black wire coming out of the servo motor is going to go to the ground on the Circuit Playground Express board. The red one goes to the 3.3 volt output, and the yellow one is our signal wire, and that goes to pin A1. Pin A2 also works with servo motors, but in the code that we have, we use A1. Now that we have our sunflower built and wired up, we're gonna move on to the code. I'm gonna take you through how I created the code and not just a line-by-line description. Hopefully that will help you out with future projects. And there are two things that are different in the code than what I'll show you on screen, and it's right in the downloadable version. One is that we only move 2 degrees at a time instead of 10, which is a lot jerkier of a movement. And the other is that we have a limit inside the flower pot. We can't go the full 180 degrees. We can only go to the left about 40 and to the right about 120. And you're gonna have to figure out this limit for whatever flower pot that you use. So let's jump into the code. Let's code the sunflower. When we go to make code.adafruit.com. This is what a starting program looks like. We have this forever block right here, and it's a loop that just keeps going again and again for, well, forever. This is the checklist that the Circuit Playground Express is gonna do. And we know that part of our checklist involves a servo. We want that to move. And if we open up the advanced tab under pins, we can go down to servo, and you can see it fits inside the forever block. So we can write the servo pin. For us, it's A1, but A2 also drives servos. And we can move it anywhere from 0 all the way up to 180. So at 90, that is the dead center, and that's where our sunflower is standing straight up. We want it to move either clockwise or counterclockwise when it's in darkness, because we want it to be able to find light. So there are a few ways that we can read light, and we can use events to read light, or we can just read a regular analog input value for light. For the event, what we could do is we could set a dark threshold value, and light goes from 0 up to 255. So 255 is the brightest, 0 is the darkest. So if we set it somewhere down here, we'll say maybe dark is anything below 60. And when we've reached that, we want something to happen. So when it's dark, we're gonna move the servo, so we could put that down here. Problem is, this only happens when we transition from, let's say this is light, and then we go below that threshold we set, then this event is gonna trigger over here. As long as we're still in darkness, nothing new is gonna happen. It only happens when it crosses this threshold that we set. We want it to continuously move when it's in darkness and find some kind of sunlight for our flower. So unfortunately, this is not gonna work. So we can just right click and we can delete our event block, and then we can also delete our threshold block. And instead, we're going to have to read this light value and make some kind of decision with it. And when we have to make decisions, we can go to our logic block. And this is an if statement. So if something is true, then we do this stuff inside. If the light value we read is too dark, then we want to move the servo. And to make a comparator, we go back to logic and we look at these little diamond shapes right here for our comparisons. And we can take this little diamond shape and it fits right up there in our true block. So if our light level that we're reading from our light sensor, that goes from 0 to 255, you can see that over here, you can move it up and down. If this is below, let's say 40, that's a pretty low number, but let's say that's our darkness. So if the light level is less than 40, then we want to move the servo. But we have another problem. This says write the servo pin 2, and then this is just one position. We want it to continuously move as long as the light level is below 40. So what we can do is we can add a variable. We'll make one called degrees. So we can change this variable degrees by, let's say, 10. So every time we come into this loop, we're gonna go up by 10. And then we would take this variable and put it over here. So if the light level is dark, so if it's below 40, then we're going to increment this degrees value that we're tracking by 10. We're gonna add 10 to it. And then the servo motor is going to move up 10. So it's only going to move until it maxes out at 180 degrees. This part's only for when it's dark. We want to do something when it's not dark, when it's light. I like to have visuals that show me what's happening. So we can change all of these to yellow when we're in the light, and that way we know that we found a nice sunny spot. We can duplicate this block, and let's say if we're in the dark area, we'll make this side blue and this side purple. So this is when our sunflower is in the darkness, and this is when it has found light. And let's run this program and see what happens. So we see that our servo is moving. It thinks it's light, so it stops. If we cover it up, then it keeps moving. And then it's going to bottom out, and it's not going to go back the other way. So we're stuck. We've only been able to go in one direction. So what we can do is we can add another logic block down here. So if this happens, then we do something. And we'll have another one of these logic statements. So let's take this out and duplicate it. And we can put this back. So if it's dark, we want it to then do this stuff, but go in the opposite direction. So we can duplicate everything we have in here too. So in this one, instead of going positive 10, we'll go negative 10. And to know which way we're going, let's make this side purple, and we'll make this side blue. It's dark, it's moving. It's light, it stops. Dark again, we keep moving. But it still only makes it that far. So we still have some logic problems. So we've tracked the number of degrees, but I think we should also be able to track the direction that we're going in. So we can make another variable called direction. And we'll say that one direction is 0, and we can track that it goes all the way in one direction and then comes back. So when I say if the degrees that I'm moving, if we've reached 0, so we've maxed out, then I'm going to say that the direction that I'm heading, I want to switch to 0. So now we're going to go clockwise. So if we've gone as far as we can counterclockwise and we've hit 0, now we're gonna switch. And we'll do the opposite if the degrees equals, and I don't wanna go all 180. I've tried that and it kind of hits a little too far, so I'm gonna say 160. So if we've hit up to 160, then I want to change the direction to 1. So we can add another part to this if statement. Down in logic, we can look for 2 conditions. So I can say if the light level is dark, so if it's below 40, and the direction we're going in is equal to 0, then we're going to increase by 10, and we'll keep increasing, and when we hit 160, we're gonna switch our direction up here to 1. So in this comparator down here, you can take this, we'll delete this because we're gonna go up to this one, this end statement, we're gonna duplicate it and bring it down here. Whoop, the whole thing. Yeah, and you wait for the little block to highlight. There we go, and right there. So now we want this one to be 1. So now in our forever loop, we're saying if we've maxed out and we've gone as far as we can in the counterclockwise direction, we're gonna set our direction to 0, and we're gonna go the opposite way. So down here, and this one says if We've maxed out in the clockwise direction. We've hit 160 degrees. Then we're going to change the status of our direction to 1. Then our Circuit Playground Express is going to see if the light level is below 40, so if it's in the dark, and its direction it's supposed to be heading in is in the clockwise direction. Then we're going to light up the lights in this pattern, and we're going to increase by 10 degrees. And then the servo is going to move that additional 10 degrees. So it could start out at 0, go 10, 20, 30, 40, all the way up to 160. And when it reaches 160, then it's going to switch direction to 1. And then it's going to come into this loop when it's dark. And it's going to increment downwards until we get to 0. So it's going to go back and forth, back and forth. And as soon as the light level is above 40, it's going to stop moving and just show this yellow light. So if we cover it up and it's in darkness, it keeps clicking away. If it hits light, it stops. And if it's in darkness again, it's gonna go all the way to one side, and then it's gonna go all the way slowly back to the other side. But anytime I take my finger away and it's light, it's gonna stop. Thanks so much for learning and building with us today. This is a playlist to all the sensors on the Circuit Playground Express board and how to use MakeCode with them. Let us know down in the comments below any projects that you're working on, and we'll see you next time.